The messages encoded in the scriptures and ancient archaeology seem to add up to spiritual science. The intent was to teach the initiates the deeper meaning of these myths. What became later termed as Lucifer, Satan, or the Devil was representative of the ego, which rivals the Lord, the representative of the self. The true self is the epicenter of a person's entire being. It is the total sum of everything that we are. The false ego, on the other hand, is the idea and concept we create about ourselves in the course of our lives, which typically excludes any qualities we don't wish to accept about ourselves. However, humanity has been endowed with the freedom to choose either to obey the true self or to give in to the temptation of the vanity and materialism of the false ego. This is the most notable trait that separates man from animals. A freedom of choice. A choice to follow our concepts and ideals or our natural impulses. A choice to sustain nature or to destroy it. This freedom of choice weighs on the fate of the entire organism that we call humanity. Answer, begin with the group of cells within humanity that fails to communicate with the conscious signal of the organism. Those cells begin to grow out of control and spread to the areas of the organism. The spread of disease is evident in our world today. The cancer upon our earth is the domination of our false ego and our divorce from nature. Collectively, among every human, the cancer upon our earth is the domination of our false ego and our divorce from nature. Collectively, among every human, vanity leads to segregation and competition. Competition leads to fear and greed. Greed leads to deceit and immorality. And immorality is the breeding ground for illness, waging war on the earth. Every act of hatred and destructiveness in our world begins with selfhood and self-destruction. And it all begins with a breakdown in communication.
Come on. Come on with me. Come on. Here we go. Jumped in with the hamsters again, huh?
In nature, all that we perceive with our five senses is a result of two fundamental principles. Everything in existence is made of a relationship between vibration and matter. Vibration is a masculine creative force powered by matter, which is a feminine receptive force. Thus begins the principle of duality. We see this duality in ancient myths and philosophies, yet only those philosophies and scriptures that were perverted and made to be original gave the impression that one polarity was good while the other was evil. The original sages, adepts, and scholars thought that both are necessary, and one would not exist without the other. These two important principles come together to form all things in the universe.
Come here, Nibbles. Come here, baby. Come on, baby. Nibbles is not a boy. He's a girl.
This phenomenon is found to be one of the prime forces that make
up biological. Well, this is their setup. There you have it.
Elvis can be.